Alon, thanks for joining us on the SEABL Preview Show. Well, today we're out at Frankston. I've been lucky enough to have been joined by one of the Blues, Chuck Long. Chuck, how are you going, mate?
I'm doing pretty good. It's kind of cold right now, but I'm going all right.
It's cold down here in Frankston, that's for sure. But, mate, how have you seen your season so far, personally?
I feel like we played good against a good team, but then we don't play the whole game, throughout the whole game against a good team. We don't concentrate through the whole game and be disciplined, and they have like a 5-minute spurt where they come back and then they take the lead and they'll pull away from us. But then after look at the rest of the game where we're in the whole game. So I think we're feeling pretty good about the way we're going so far. We just need to tweak a couple things and then we'll be fine.
Competition's so tight this year though, really, isn't it? I mean, you guys have got an 8-6 winning record, but you're still outside the top four. It's very tight.
Yeah, after the changing of the conferences, I feel like our side's a little bit stronger than the other side.
Yep.
Like, but we, even though we've lost to Knox and Hobart from the other side, I'm not trying to say that they're not any good, but like we do have a tougher conference when we got Geelong and we got Bendigo, Dandenong. They're all three teams are like you can be probably looking at to win the grand final.
All right, mate, plenty to get through, lots to talk about, but we'll push on and get through some news. The player of the week this week was Tim Conrads. I don't think you've come up against him, but Ballarat, they're one of those teams a bit like yourself, just outside the four that can you know, maybe make a late run towards the playoffs.
Yeah, Ballarat, they got a bunch of young guys, and they go hard the whole time. There's never a break. Even if they're down, they're always trying to go at it. I played against Conrad once last year up in when he played for Mackay and up at Rock Hampton.
Yep.
He's a great scorer. He's a great competitor as well. So he's probably added a lot for them as well.
In other news, there's news filtering through that some teams, Ballarat, the Pioneers and the Gunners are all looking to secure imports before the deadline this Friday. The imports in general this year, Chuck, have just been fantastic. You've got a great one here at Frankston.
Yeah, Calvin, he's done a lot for us. He's our leading scorer and rebounder, and I think he leads the league in block shots as well. He's just does a little bit of everything, and he's what he said he would be able to do. He said he'd play any position if he had to, so he's been great for the team.
Yeah, he's certainly great to watch, very athletic. We'll push on and look at some of the star performers this week. We'll keep talking about imports, Chuck. Kamani Barrett, top of the scorers there, and you come up against him this week.
Yeah, Kamani, he's a difficult one to guard. He can, I think it was said before, he can score inside, he can shoot the three, he can dribble, he does a little bit of everything. He's a pretty tough guy to guard. You just got to get up on him early and kind of deny him the ball before he can get it.
And in the leading rebounders there, Eric Gaff leading the rebounds, and you come up against him as well this weekend.
Yeah, I remember last year playing against Gaff. He's long and he's fairly athletic for his height as well. He's always around the rim, and like even if you think he have him boxed out, he just got the length over you. He just reaches over you and grabs it, and it's just kind of frustrating going against him.
We'll push on, Chuck, and look at our game previews this week. As we touched on there, you were up against Geelong down at the arena this weekend. It's always a tough assignment to go down there and get a win.
Yeah, Geelong is probably the MBL of the SEABL. Like their arena is really nice down there. Yeah. They got great support down there with their followers, and they seem to shoot a lot better down there as well. So it's gonna be tough.
We've talked about Kamani Barrett, their other import, Theron Wilson. He plays a good supporting role, I think, to Kamani.
Yeah, I think they complement each other very well.
Yeah.
Kamani is probably more of the scorer. Theron, he's does everything else. Like he plays defense. He's very aggressive on defense. And if he gets an open lane to the basket, then pretty much everybody's gonna move out of the way because he's taking off. He's just like Ishmael, almost like as athletic as he was as well. So they're both pretty good.
Yeah, it's good to hear your thoughts on their imports. But I also had the opportunity to ask Jamie O'Loughlin, the head coach of the Geelong Supercats, his thoughts on the Frankston imports.
I think their imports are very good. I mean, we know Chuck has been a very good player for some time in this league. So, you know, he's always something to deal with. And I don't know, Runchie just keeps on coming up with really good, talented foremen. And, you know, we've got another one again. So their imports are high quality. And, you know, we experienced that when we played them down there last time. It took a lot of work to try to keep them in check. I'm sure they're going to want to, you know, come out again and be firing. So, you know, they're a tough team. I actually see them a lot like us in many ways. So, you know, that's always going to be a difficult matchup.
We'll push on, Chuck, and have a look at your other game this weekend. You're hosting Northwest Tasmania. They've been a bit up and down this year, but certainly they've got the firepower to really cause some headaches.
Yeah, I think Adam Ben Armstrong always helps any side. Yeah. He's a veteran of the league. He's already in the top five in assists. I mean, he gets it done. He's tough to guard. And then you got Sean Teeth Gary, who's, like, I guess he's came alive as well since Ben started playing. And he's starting to be a prolific scorer like he was last year as well.
Yeah, we were talking off camera that he's jumped up now into the top five scorers. And when he gets his swagger back, you know, he's very hard to stop.
Yeah, he is really hard to stop. I've guarded him a few times in Tassie and up here. He's really hard to stop. I mean, once he gets a full steam ahead going, he's going to the basket. It's kind of hard to get him, stay in front of him. And if he's knocking down jump shots, it's hard as well. So.
Yeah, you would have seen a lot of these Tassie guys with your time from the Chargers. Does that give you an advantage? Do you know any sort of inside information about the Thunder?
Yeah, because I played also in the Northwest Tag League, so I played against them like once a week, and then I played against them twice throughout the season with the Chargers. But with those guys, I know a little of different things that they don't like to do or they do like to do, so I try to imply that with them when I play against them here, so see if it still works.
Can you give away any secrets, mate?
I can't do that.
Awesome. Well, we'll push on and look at the conference ladders, starting with the East Conference. As we touched on at the top there, Chuck, you're just outside the top four, but those teams in front of you, like you said, Geelong, Dandenong, Bendigo, Sandringham, all very tough.
Yeah, they are really tough. Positive thing with us is we felt like we played bad most beginning the first half of the season, but we're still only two games out of the top three.
Yeah.
So we're still, like, we have a positive ending, hopefully.
Mm. And in the other conference, Knox, Albury Wodonga, Nunna Wadding, have you seen those teams? Who do you like out of that conference?
Well, you always got to like Knox. Yeah. I mean, they every year they're always in the finals, so you got to be positive with them.
Yeah.
And then Albury is a surprise package there. I mean, they went from being not winning games last year to being second on the ladder. And then now the Wadding is going to be pretty good as well.
Mm.
But for some reason, I like to say that Hobart will probably be in the top four just because it's just the Hobart
smoky
way.
Yeah, so. They're tough, aren't they? Especially down there. And if they can get some momentum going, watch out for sure with Hobart.
Yeah, I definitely agree, especially with the way Brandon's been playing lately.
Yeah.
And now that he got some shooters where they have to leave him one-on-one, so it's kind of hard to guard them as well.
Yeah, Brandon's having a real all-star type season. Seems like he's fit, he's healthy, he's hungry. What was he like to play around?
He was a great guy to play around. Like, he would always get double teamed in the post, so I'm just like out here just doing whatever I want to do, crash the board. Nobody really worried about me because they worry about, oh, Brandon, he's the one that starts. So I'm like, yep, keep going to Brandon. So, but he's a great teammate as well. Like, worked hard at training, worked hard in games. He's a very great competitor.
Well, we're almost getting near towards the end of the show now. We'll have a look at this week's upcoming fixtures. Chuck, are you one of those people that when you're not playing, you tend to go and watch other games, or do you tend to just take a break?
I tend to take a break.
Yeah.
I watch film on other teams, but then I don't go to live games.
Yeah. Mate, I know you're enjoying your time here at Frankston. It seems like there's a really good camaraderie amongst the group.
Yeah, we get along great. We're together off the court all the time as well, from managers to the coaching staff. Everybody gets along as a team.
Well, I was lucky enough to travel with you guys down to Canberra earlier this year, and we're at the airport, and all of a sudden you guys have just donned all these T-shirts. Can you tell us a bit about that?
We had a function after the season last year, and we saw some pictures of our assistant coach, Brett Rolfe, and a picture of our manager, John Miltos, and we was like, oh, we got to get that on a T-shirt. So I called my buddy up down in Hobart, Tony Blackwell, who does T-shirts and trophies and stuff, and I got him to send me some shirts up. So
show us one of the shirts you've got on here with us.
Yeah, so we got our assistant coach right there. That one.
And on the back?
And then on the back, we got our manager. So, yeah, it was a bit of fun. All the guys enjoyed it. We actually consulted Bill about it first, and he was okay with it. So.
Now, talking about team camaraderie, Chuck, I also know that the Frankston Blues have a fine system in place for the players when they appear on the website. you're going to be up for one hell of a fine after this, aren't you?
Yeah, I've already talked about it. I think I got at least $5 coming my way, so it might be more.
$5, they're letting you off easy, mate.
Yeah, I hope so.
Well, mate, I think that does it for us for today's show. It's been great having you on it. I hope you enjoyed it.
That was great.
Yeah, awesome. And good luck this weekend. But remember, you can always get the latest headlines by following us on Facebook or on Twitter. Until next week, it's bye for now.